Hello, my fellow courtiers. The question of the day comes from Marshall. I have started going to college. What advice could you please give me that could incorporate the 48 laws of power in it? Okay, so the first thing comes from experience, which is don't mistake isolation for independence. Don't be afraid to ask for help if you're having trouble with your studies. Don't be afraid to help others or form alliances. Without external forces, you lose touch with reality. Without different and challenging views, you remain stagnant. Building connections is quite important. So the biggest advantage that Ivy League university students have is the exposure to elite teachers and students. Their connections help them to become extremely powerful in the long run. Think of the PayPal Mafia members, for example. Elon Musk and Peter Thiel are still allies to this day. My point is, college creates the same opportunities because there are elite people everywhere, not just in Harvard or Stanford or Yale. Find them, learn from them. If you spend time around procrastinators or completely on your own, you won't reap the benefits. If you are too shy or introverted, seek clubs with similar interests. Once you realize that humans are just that, humans, build from there and spend time around people with different views. Being around others provides us with perspective, which brings me to the next point. Number 2, college or university is a chance to kill prejudices. You see that YouTube is bombarded with videos from college students trying to spread their own ideologies. But it depends on your mindset. How are you going to deal with it? Are you gonna isolate yourself or learn from it? College attracts people from all different walks of life, different values, habits, customs, and views. Their ideas and attitudes are different from yours, yes, which might create a threat to your sense of self. To protect ourselves, we form prejudices and we create an us versus them dynamic. We might see a guy who gets laid a lot as an F-boy out of envy, or assume a woman who scores high on exams to not have a life. We can view people who use recreational drugs as losers. Whatever your prejudice is, challenge it by infiltrating different groups or communicating with these individuals. You do this by generally being curious, talking to them about your prejudice, confessing it, or showing a willingness to learn. If you ask most people to teach you something, you instantly gain their respect and gain points in their eyes. If you choose to keep yourself and your values, you will move to the professional realm, thinking that certain people are enemies. It will inflame your insecurities. College is great because you don't have to look for these people. They come to you with less effort. So, view it as a chance to challenge your mindset and to experiment. Number 3. Create an identity around being a learner instead of being intelligent. If you fail to learn a subject or tackle a problem, you can always learn the right approach. If you make intelligence the center of your identity, you will get crushed time and time again with every little challenge that you go through. There are two types of people. Those with a growth mindset, which believe that their inner qualities in cognition can be developed. On the other hand, there are people with fixed mindset, who assume nothing will change. And if they can't solve a problem now, that means they are not good enough. Most will assume they have a growth mindset, but they don't. They have what's called a false growth mindset. Just because someone has self-esteem, they assume to possess one. At any rate, step number 1 is to see yourself as a learner. Step number 2 is to push yourself towards the uncomfortable and challenge yourself daily. Maybe you tackle things that you're not good at instead of practicing and practicing the things that you are good at. Because most of the time, that's just a sign of escapism. So there is a book called Mindset by Carol Dweck that provides a lot of examples for this. You might want to check it out. Number 4. You treat college as a mission. You're preparing for war. They say prepare for war in the time of peace, which is right. So it's the perfect time to make mistakes. Treat your college experience as a rite of passage. I would extremely recommend you work on your communication the most because it leads to all types of jobs. Find a debate club or a Toastmasters types of thing if you can. If you can't, maybe think of creating one. Maybe you should build that initiative muscle. Number 5. There is a famous quote. Whoever has taught me one letter, has made me his slave. So don't disrespect your teachers, because that will bite you in the ass. Even if they overwhelm you with work, it's a chance to get better. You are merely forging yourself. Even when things start badly, or a relationship between you and a teacher or another student takes a hit, it doesn't mean it's over. It doesn't mean it's doomed. Remember that hate in intensity can quickly turn to love with some mental judo, through generosity of spirit and showing a willingness to learn from others. You can convert most people. Whenever you come across a group, ask yourself, who is the most underappreciated member? Investigate them. Find their talents. You will be surprised by the amount of value they can give you. Find a teacher who is underappreciated and feed and nurture their need to be seen and heard. Last thing I would say is that the 48 Laws of Power is a helpful guide to social dynamics, but if you obsess with it, you'll become overly paranoid. Cunning is the offspring of incapacity, said La Rochefoucauld. So, seek mastery first. Keep cunning in mind, but don't forget about genuine empathy. I hope this helps.